An old Cherokee is teaching his grandson about life. A fight is going on inside me, he said to the boy. It is a terrible fight and is between two wolves. One is evil, he is anger, envy, sorrow, regret, greed, arrogance, self-pity, guilt, resentment, inferiority, lies, false pride, superiority, and ego. He continued. The other is good. He is joy, peace, love, hope, serenity, humility, kindness, benevolence, empathy, generosity, truth, compassion, and faith. The same fight is going on inside you and inside every other person too. The grandson thought about it for a minute and then he asked his grandfather, which wolf will win? The old Cherokee simply replied, the one you feed. Welcome to this episode of the Martial Art Innovation Podcast. Let's get started. Frack, your host. I'm the owner and instructor at Martial Art Innovations, a self-defense and fitness-based martial arts school in Covina, California. Today we're talking about A Tale of Two Wolves. This fable has been around for a very long time. I've heard several slight variations of it, and I actually used it as a topic of discussion in our mat chats. That's where we have talks at the end of class at my studio. And so I thought I'd share with you some of the things I shared with the students on what I thought that the grandfather meant when the boy asked him, which wolf will win? And the grandfather replies, the one you feed. So I think there are several factors that will, quote, feed the wolves within us. I think the first one is your mood or your state of mind that you're in. Often that's affected by your sleep, your lack thereof of sleep, your overall level of fatigue, whether or not you're hungry. Some people, you know, they get, as they say, hangry. If you're experiencing illness, if you're under a certain amount of stress, all of these things can affect your mood or your state. And I think that contributes greatly to the wolf you feed, if you will. I also think our general perceptions will affect this. Things like our family upbringing, the values we've adopted from our family, the values we may have adopted as adults, as well as our life experiences definitely have an effect on our perceptions. The things that we consume have an effect on us. So for example, what we consume with our eyes, things like movies, video games, social media, life experiences, things that we witness with our eyes have definitely a huge impact on which side of us comes forward in other situations in life. Another example is what we consume with our ears, the kind of music that we listen to, the kind of conversations that we have with others, and even our own thoughts. Because when you're thinking in your own head, you're still listening to that voice that's there. So what we consume with our ears can also have a great impact on us. Perhaps one of the most influential areas on us is the relationships we have with other people in our life. Now, some of these we might not have much control over, like family members or coworkers that we have to deal with. But the people that we choose to associate ourselves with, that's very important. You know, there's an old saying, if you lie down with dogs, you get up with fleas. Now, I don't believe that's true. I think it's much closer to if you lie down with dirty dogs, you may get up with fleas. But if you have good dogs around you, you're more likely to be influenced positively. So we want to choose the people we surround ourselves with very carefully because they're going to have a huge impact on us and in our life. Now, with all that being said, I'm not saying just because you watch something violent or listen to music that has violent words in it, that it's going to mean you're going to be a violent person. It does have that effect on some people. I'm just saying that overall, the amount of things that we consume, our mood, our relationships, all of these things collectively have an effect on what comes out of us. Now, in general, I believe people by nature are good. I think if you get a movie theater full of people who watch a horror slasher film and they come out of that theater, I don't think you're going to have a large population that decides they want to become slasher killers. Maybe it might affect somebody that way. I can't say, but I do believe the opposite of that. I think if you have a movie theater full of people watching a movie about someone who's overcoming challenges through their life, an inspirational story, I definitely think that's going to have a powerful message with people, and I think it's more likely to affect them on a greater scale. So therefore, if that's the case, let's try to make sure that we take in as much positive material as possible. Make sure that the movies that we watch, the kind of music that we listen to are uplifting and powerful. Now, I'm not saying don't go and watch scary movies, don't listen to music with bad language in it, but what I'm saying, try to make sure that we consume as much positivity as possible and surround ourselves with as many positive people as possible. Thank you for joining me on this episode of the Martial Art Innovations Podcast. If you're not already subscribed, please consider doing so so you'll receive future episodes. And please share this with a friend who you think might enjoy it. And if you could, leave a comment down in the comment section. Let me know what you thought of the episode, what you might like to hear on future episodes as well. If you'd like more information about me or my school, you can contact me at martialartinnovations.com. That's my website. We also have social media for our school on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Again, thank you for listening and for your support. Please join me on the next episode. Take care.